morning. Let us start some more sessions of coding theory. In the last few sessions, we have understood some interesting features of coding theory. Especially in the last session, we introduced an interesting concept of coding theory known as distance between two codes, two words. That is, using a function e, one function e, we used to code a given word from one dimension to the other dimension, from m dimension to the n dimension. And the next one is we introduced what is known as weight of the word, which are number of 1, 0 or 1s are there, number of 1s appearing in it. And using this weight also, we connected weight and distances. And afterwards, if at all we can find all the possibilities of distances, the next important thing is minimum distance definitely helps to find whether a given coded word can be decoded or whether there is a error or not. So, detection of error and correction of error is possible or not, this will be found using the minimum distance. So, let us have a glimpse of that. So, what we did? So, taken any word, so number of 1s we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this becomes the weight of the number word, which is a binary digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 belonging to the z to the power 7, a 7 dimension you can call very loosely. Similarly, weight of this word is number of 1s here, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so that the weight of this word is 8. So, we can either denote it by modulus of x or wt of x, but how do we connect the distance and the weight? Before that, let us see the distance between two words. If at all I take two words from the same dimension, m dimension, then the distance between these two words, d of xy we denote, is nothing but number of positions in which they are not same, number of positions in which they are differing. Like x1 is not equal to xy1, this is one difference like that. In how many positions from 1 to m? Maximum they can differ in m positions. If they are same, they are not differing, only 0. So, distance can be 0 to maximum m in m dimension. So, that we readily observe that this distance of xy is number of 1s in x plus y also, that is weight of x plus y also. We shall observe by these examples. Weight of x, so it should be weight here, weight of x, for example, weight of the first one, weight of the first one is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Weight of the second one, this is weight of x, weight of y. So, weight of y is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, we can find the weight like this. So, similarly, can you find difference distance between x and y using the weight, that is distance concept? See that we can find this weight. If I add x and y, 1 plus 0 1, 0 plus 1 1, and 1 plus 1 0 third position, fourth position 1 plus 0 1, like that we can get 0 0, because 1 plus 1 is 0 in modulus 2, 0 plus 0 0, 1 plus 1 again here it should be 0. So, that it should be 0 here. So, that weight is 1 1 1, which is 3. So, distance between x and y is also weight of x plus y, like that we can prove. So, we observed readily that this distance follows the usual distance concepts, which is distance between x y is same thing as distance between x y, y x. Distance between x y is greater than or equal to 0. The distance between x y is 0 if and only if they are same points. So, distance of x y plus distance of y z is less than or equal to x z. See that this is a important concept to be understood, if at all any distance to be called as a distance. So, it should be y x here. So, hence we call this distance as d as a function d or a matrix D. So hence, if at all we want to understand the next coding functions, then we need to understand this distance very clearly. This D is known as distance or a matrix, or specially known as Hamming matrix. Of course, this pair together with D, we call it as a Hamming matrix space. Let us see sphere for A belonging to any z to the power m and positive integer k like 0, 1, 2, 3. We define a sphere of radius k with center A as set of all x belonging to this z to the power m, which are such that distance between any x and this A should be less than or equal to k. For example, if at all I take 3 here and center as 0, 1, 1, these are all points whose distances are at the most 2, For example, if I take distance between this and this, then they are differing in two positions. If I take the distance between these two, then they are differing in two positions, maximum one position. You can see that only one position they are differing, first and last, 0 first position and 1 first position, they are differing. These two positions are same. So, distance between A and this is 1, which is less than or equal to 2. Like that, if I cover all these, this set itself is known as sphere with the center A and radius 2. Now, we shall quickly see what is minimum distance also. Suppose a encoding function is there from 2 dimension to 6 dimension. So, what we did, in 2 dimension there are 4 possibilities of strings 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. So, from all these 4, amongst each we can find 6 distances, like from 0 this code word to remaining 3, this code word to the remaining 2, 3 plus 2, 5, this code word to the one more remaining, which is 1, 6. So, if at all we have found like that the distances, for example, 0, 0 and 1, 1, 0, 0 and 1, 1, in all the 6 positions they are differing, between E of 0, 0 and E of 1, 1, the distance is 6. Let us find between 1, 0 and 1, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, this diagonally cross. So, first position same, second position different. So, wherever 0 is there, they are differing. So, that they are differing in 3 positions, distance between this code word and this code word is 3, that is 1, 0, 1, 1, if you remember. 1 0 1 0 1 1 is 3. Like that, out of all the 6 distances possible, see which is maximum is 6, minimum is 3. We catch hold of the minimum and call it as a minimum distance of this code word, this code function E, or minimum distance of code words, or minimum E, or short min E, or delta E is 3. So, this delta E is a very powerful tool for detection and correction errors like this. Correction and detection. Suppose in the last case we found these 2 dimension, 6 dimension, all these words, all these distances, and suppose in one of the cases, suppose we have got 5 as the minimum distance, say 5 as a minimum distance, leave apart this. Suppose in any code function 5 is a minimum distance, then take delta minus 1, 4, 5 minus 1. So, whatever the errors are there, if the weights of the errors are less than or equal to 4, then it can be detected. If delta minus 1 by 2, if you find 5 minus 1, 4 by 2, 2, if the weights of the errors are less than or equal to 2, they can be corrected. So, for example, so 2, 2, 6, all these we have taken. So, find minimum E, error detection, error correction capacities. What is meant by that? Found all the weights, maximum 6, minimum 3, catch hold of minimum 3, delta, find delta minus 1, 5 minus 1, 4. So, all the errors with weight 4 or less than 4 means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 weights, those errors can be corrected. Correcting capacity is 4. Similarly, that is detecting capacity is 4. Correcting capacity is delta minus 1 by 2, which is 3 minus 1 by 2, which is we can find 2 minus 1 by 2, which is 1. So, maximum 1, the errors correcting capacity is 1 here, because 3 minus 1 by 2 equal to is 1. So, similarly, if at all I take 3 dimension to 6 dimension, suppose in 3 dimension there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 possibilities of the words. Out of 8 possibilities, 8C2, what is 8C2? 8C2 possibilities of distances will be there. 8C2 possibilities of distances means, can you tell me what is, how many distances are possible, which are 4 into 7, 28 possibilities of distances. So, out of all these 28 possibilities, if you find, it will be looking like this, that is from 0, 0 to 1, 1, all these distances like that, all you find, see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28 distances possible. You can see that maximum is 6 and minimum is 2 here. So, there can be many maximums, there can be many minimums. So, hence we catch hold of this minimum distance and call it as minimum E is 2. Find minimum E means you have to find all possible distances. But important thing, what we looked, how many total distances are possible, whether 8C2 or 6C2 or 7C2 is depending on, in 3 dimension 8 possibilities are there, so 8C2 like that. In 2 dimension there were 4 possibilities, out of 4 possibilities 4C2 distances are possible. So, now coming back to this error detecting capacity, so 2 minus 1, that is a 1. The errors of error detecting capacity is 1, so all the errors of weight less than or equal to 1 can be detected. Correction half means there is no weight of half, error of weight half, hence we cannot correct any error, which we write corrected. This means that E cannot correct any error. So, this concept we use to learn our next important concept, what is known as generator matrix or parity check matrix. So, shall we learn what is generator matrix and parity check matrix? Today we shall learn generator matrix and parity check matrix. So, it is quite interesting. So, we have seen many functions for coding E of certain function 0, 1, equal to 0, 1, 0, something like that, where E is defined in different fashions. But now, interestingly, whether this E can be a matrix, whether this E can be a matrix. So, quickly we shall see how E can be a matrix. For that reason, slowly you consider a matrix. Suppose, what I consider a matrix? So, let me consider a matrix, suppose some G matrix. G matrix can be something like, first I consider a unit matrix, suppose, which is of order 1, 0 and 0, 1. Then I add some more columns to this. Let me add any number of columns, but in terms of 0s and 1s, which are, suppose, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. So, this is a 2 cross 2 matrix. This totally becomes a 2 cross 5 matrix, which I use to transfer a word from 2 dimension to the word from 5 dimension. How? For that, anyway, this E, the work of E is done by G. This I should use for to transfer a word of 2 dimension 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1 and 1, 1. All these words I should transfer to 5 dimension. That is, I want E from 2 dimension to 5 dimension. So, here E is from 2 dimension to 5 dimension, but we want to talk in general, suppose it can be a different structure like this. G can be E1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Slash any number of columns you add. Suppose for simplicity I add 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. This is 3 cross 3 matrix. I take it as M cross M, M cross M, and I make it as M cross N totally. This is our M cross n. So what will be our m cross n here? M is same, number of rows are 3, number of columns 3 more added 6. Can we write a general matrix like this, thinking that there is a unit matrix of certain order n cross n, m cross m here, and there is one more matrix of order whatever you get, that is a non square matrix or square matrix here, any square, any matrix with zeros and ones again, that we call it as a G matrix. Let us consider this general G matrix. So what is this? Any unit matrix 0 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 slash some matrix here A 1 1 A 1 2 and A 1 K suppose, because this I am going to take M cross M, and this I am going to take M plus 1, M plus 2, M plus K. So similarly, if I write the second one A 2 1, A 2 2, A 2 K, can you tell me the last one? Mth row A M 1, A M 2, A M K. So totally like this, we generate here M cross M I matrix, and remaining if it is M cross N, where this N is nothing but M plus K. So in general I wrote I for I here, and some matrix here which we call by some name A, suppose some name A. What is the order of A? The order of A will be, rows will be same, and totally N minus M, so N minus M. Hence we have two matrices, one is M cross M, one is M cross N minus M. Now this acts as our coding function E, that is our main concentration, let us not forget, equivalent to coding function E. For that I have to take some word of length, so this will transfer from M dimension to N dimension. Very similarly, this will transfer from 2 to 5, from 3 to 6. So here this is from Z2 to the power 3 to Z2 to the power 6, 3, 6, here M, N. Let me take a word from M dimension, I want it to transfer to the word from N dimension via this E, or instead of E, G. So let us break the suspense, why, how this G is doing it. For that I'll, let me take a word W, W1, W2, Wm from M dimension, so that I will apply, I make it a matrix and I multiply by this G matrix. Is it possible? This matrix is 1 cross M matrix G, this is our G matrix, is M cross N, M cross N matrix is multiplication is possible. Output matrix will be 1 cross N, so 1 row, 1 row, something like W1, W2, Wm and Wm plus 1 up to Wn. So how do we get this? Let us say actually by multiplying W1, W2, Wm into this matrix 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, so on, we are going to get 0, 0, 1 slash all these A11, A12, A1k, A21, A22, A2k and so on, AM1, AM2, AMk. So that let us multiply these two matrices, which is known as WG matrix, and we are going to get it as first row to first column. Very easy, first row to first column, W1 into 1 and remaining all are multiplied to 0, 0, 0. So W1 plus all 0, we get W1 as the first entry of this. So which we are going to generate as 1 cross N is our output matrix. I am going to get a 1 cross N matrix. Similarly, if I multiply to the second row, I am going to get W2. If I multiply to the, this is M cross M, if I multiply to the mth column, till that Wm is same. But for Wm plus 1, which are Wm plus 1, can you observe what happens? If I multiply to this m plus 1th column, this is m column, or this is m plus 1 column, let us multiply. For example, Wm plus 1 equal to W1 into A11, W2 into A21, last Wm into Am1. First column is multiplied, that is 1, 1, 1 is there, which I can write W1 Am1, W2 Am2, and last one, so on, Wm Am1. This we are writing it as Wm plus 1. Similarly, quickly we can write Wm plus 2, which is wherever this 1 is there, this you are going to get it as 2. So, W2, this is W1 A11, W2 A21, W3 A31, and Wm Am1. So, now if at all you take Wm plus 2, you have to multiply to this m plus 2 column, this is m plus 1 column. So, instead of 1, 1, 1 here, you will get 2, 2, 2 here, means second suffix, you are going to get it as 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, which is W1, A12, W2, A22, and so on, Wm, Am2. But here we should not forget that all these entries are zeros and ones. As long as we are in coding theory of binary symmetric channel, we are using only zeros and ones. Here also zeros and ones, output will be also one of the zeros and ones. Hence this code generated, instead of m dimension code, these are added extra. All together we are going to get n dimensional code, m to n dimensional code. So if at all we write the last one Wm plus k, so instead of 1 or 2 I have to write k here, W1 k, W2 A22 k, and last one Wm Am k. This suppose we call it as some star, these are going to determine these code words. So these are our parity check equations. So hence this is generating these extra codes which should be appended or added. Hence we call this as a generator matrix. So G itself we call it as a generator matrix G. So once having understood what is generator matrix, so let us take one example how it will generate also. But before that we write, if at all it is transferred, how to decode it back, if at all suppose it is already in n dimension. For that we do a special matrix known as parity check matrix. So what is happened here, totally this G matrix is some I matrix of order m cross m slash some A matrix of order m cross n minus m. This is our final understanding of G matrix. So now if at all I want to come back, then I generate what is known as, here we shall discuss what is known as parity check matrix. How do I generate H? So that from n dimensional transferred word or coded word to again m dimension back. For that simply we write like this. First of all I write A transpose. So readily you can tell me the order of this A transpose. So that is n minus m cross m. So we add here the corresponding unit matrix. Naturally how many rows are there? So n minus 1 m rows are there. So I have to add 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 and at last 0 0 1, which is n minus m cross n minus m. So rows are fixed. What is the order of this H? H is rows are fixed, n minus m rows only. And what is the column? Let us see, up to this there are m columns and added together n minus m columns. So addition of these two, m is getting cancelled, n columns. So our H is n minus m cross n matrix. So this itself acts as our parity check matrix. How it acts as a parity check matrix? How do I get m dimensional code back. Suppose w1 w2 wm is something like transfer to r1 r2 rn. Let this be our received word r. Now we don't know what is to be here, or we just decode it back, which is from n dimension to m dimension. So this d function, how do you use? Instead of d function, this h. Instead of e function, this g. Like this, in both coding and decoding, we have introduced the matrix, hence generator matrix and parity check parity matrix. So let us use this word r. Suppose r is r1 r2 rn. Our d is from, which is n to m dimension, but instead of d, I would like to write here h. How this h is transferring? For that, we should consider, which we shall call it as decoding methodology or scheme. Consider this n, h you take. What is the order of h? Just now we have seen h is n minus m cross n. So now this is 1 cross n. This is 1 cross n. If I take the r transpose, then r transpose, then it will be n cross 1. Matrix is admissible, matrix is possible. So output is n minus m cross 1 column matrix. So now this we are going to generate one column matrix like n minus m cross 1. So we are going to get some, this we call it as syndrome. So what we did, consider H matrix, H R transpose, you find output will be some column matrix. Now what is the main scheme? What is the algorithm for this? The algorithm to find m dimensional decoding term, first of all we have to check H. This H should not possess first these two properties. What are those two properties? Let us see. First one is, it should not have any zero columns, no zero columns. And in H, identical terms should not be there, identical columns should not be there. Like 1 1 0 1 1 0, like that, two identical columns should not be there. That is, no two columns are same. Ci is not equal to Cj in H. If this happens, then only we have to proceed. Before finding HRT, we can check this before this only, check. Then if it is satisfied, then you can proceed ahead. If this happens, then proceed, then if this syndrome, what should happen to syndrome? There are different possibilities of syndrome. Suppose the syndrome is all zero column, this is a possibility. Then what we should do is, whatever the r1 r2 rn is there, the same thing you should retain. We should not treat anything, just take the first m words of this. Why m? Because it has come from m dimension. We can see the basic generator matrix, which is m cross n, so that we should retain first m, so that retain this first m as it is. Suppose it is not 0 but equal to some other column, which is 1 1 0 1, something like this. Suppose it is equal to ith column of H. Suppose you compare this column to the H matrix, it will be 1 2 3 up to, there are n columns. One of the n columns, if it is same, suppose it is equal to the second column. This second you should catch hold of, then come to this second word, second signal R2, change this. That is, if it is 1, you change to 0, if it is 0, you change to 1. that is if 00 retain same r, if second column say change r to, that is 0 to 1 and 1 to 0, after changing this r2 to 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, again first m entries is our decoded term. So I am repeating, if it is 0 0 0 as it is, first m entries, if it is equal to one of the columns, suppose say second column, then second should be changed. If it is equal to third column, third should be changed. Then after changing, again retain first m words as a decoded. The third possibility, suppose nothing happens, okay, if both first and second possibility doesn't happen, then you can't decode only using our generator matrix scheme. Of course, this is our theory part. Whatever we discussed was how this generator matrix helps to decode a m dimension number to n dimension number, that is a m dimension word we call, and how we decode using this parity check matrix. This H we call it as a parity check matrix. Of course, these equations are also known as parity check equations. So then to do that decoding scheme, suppose you consider one n dimensional code, that is n dimensional word, you take HRT, that is a column matrix here, then we get a output as one more column matrix. If the output is column matrix, if it is 0 0 0, then retain as it is some m. If it is equal to some other column of H, change that corresponding, suppose R2, if it is second column here, to 0 or 1, retain M. If this doesn't happen, then you cannot check it. For example, suppose we shall see some example using actual example like 2 cross 5 matrix. So if at all we take some example here, if it is 2 cross 5, how it will work? Suppose let me have some generator matrix G equal to 2 cross 5. In 2 cross 5, this is our identity matrix. So I want to take 2 cross 5, you can take 2 cross 6, 2 cross 7, 3 cross 6, 3 cross 7, anything. Then if at all let me add some 3 columns, 1 0, 1 1, 0 1, anything you can add. You can add 1 1, 1 0 here, 0 1, any combination. Using this, how do I generate some two dimensional words to 5 dimensional using this G? What is that E acting here? Instead of E, how I use G? For example, what are the different possibilities of words here? 00, 01, 10, 11. So how do I find this? This is our word W. This is our word W. So W, which is into I multiply this matrix G, into I multiply this matrix G, this is our WG matrix. Everywhere WG matrix I use, WG, WG, WG. So now if at all I write this 0 0 to this G matrix, see actually this is happening now, 1 0 0 1, this is a G matrix we have considered. Can you just write the output? Let us write the output here. So this output is 0 0 to first column. Of course, we are going to get 0. This is not a much difficult task. 0 0 to second column. Everywhere we are going to get first column, second column, third column, fourth column, fifth column. So this 0 0 to second column, 0. Similarly, 5 zeros we are going to generate. So the code word of this 0 0 is 5 zeros. Let me say, suppose the second one is 0 1 to this matrix 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 1. For example, this 0 1 you multiply to the first column, 0 to 1 0, 1 to 0 0, so that we are going to generate 0 to 1, that is multiply 0 into 1 0, 1 into 0, 0. So those two we are adding again. Next one, 0 to 0, 0, 1 to 1, 1, add these two to get 1. Like that, you take this to the third column also. Third column is here, 0 into 0, 0 into 1 and 1 into 0, giving us 0. Fourth column, 0 here and 1 here, and fifth column, 1. So we are going to generate this 5 dimensional code for this 0, 1. Similarly, very similarly, we can find for 1, 0, 1, 0 it is, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, which is, can you tell quickly, so this is 1, this is 0, here to here 1, here to here 1 into 1, and here to here again 1 into 0, 0 into 1. So let us complete this by taking the last one as 1, 1, this matrix 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, which is, so again here 5 dimensional. So 1, 1, 2, 1, 0, first 1, 1 to 1, 1 to 0, second 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1 to 0, 1 to 1, 1 only, third 1, 1 to 1, fourth 1, 1 to 1, 1 to 1. So this is interesting, fourth 1 is 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1, this becomes our 0, and the last one, 1, 0, 1, 1. So, we are going to generate this code. So, hence in this fashion, we are using G matrix, this G matrix to generate the 5 dimensional code. Similarly, you can reverse the, H matrix also. For example, let us take this decoding. To write the decoding, many times a question is asked, given a G matrix, simply write what is H matrix, given a generator matrix, what is parity check matrix, a simple question is there. So shall we write very simple, H is our parity check matrix, H is equal to, first you transpose this A matrix, means A transpose. So what is this, this column should come here as this, this row should come here as this column, 1, 1, 0 row, 1, 1, 0 column, 0, 1, 1 row, 0, 1, 1 column. Then correspondingly a unit matrix, so 1, 2, 3 rows are there, corresponding 3 cross 3 matrix, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Like that, simply we wrote a parity check matrix. Once again, this A matrix, its transpose, which is 1, 1, 0, here 1, 1, 0 as a column, 0, 1, 1 row, 0, 1, 1 row as second column. Because there are 3 rows here, 1, 2, 3 rows, we should write 3 cross 3 matrix. So this totally becomes 3 cross 6 matrix. So then earlier one given was, it was 2 cross 5, 2 cross 5 matrix. So here it has become 3 cross 6 matrix. So that does not matter. Now our aim is to understand how this is decoding. So let us take some 5 dimensional numbers. Suppose I take one number from this, which is 01001. Suppose R is our 01011. How to decode it from 5 dimension to 2 dimension back? For that, we have to find H R power T, which is, H is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. R power T, which is 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So what is the order of this matrix? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the order of this matrix? Only one column, How many rows? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So matrix multiplication is possible. We are going to generate a 3 cross 1 matrix. Let us actually do that. Actually, if you do that 3 cross 1 matrix, first column, first row to first this column, 1 into 0, 0 into 1, 1 into 1, 0 into something, again 0 into something here. Totally get 1 here, that is entered as 1. Next one, 1 into 0, 0 plus 1 into 1, 1 plus 0 plus fourth entry plus 1, fifth entry plus 0. Totally 1 plus 1 becomes 0 here. The last one, 0 into 0, 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 0 into 1 plus last one is again 1 into 1. Totally 1 plus 1 is 0. Like that we found a column matrix here. Now this matrix will be, this column will be compared to the actual H matrix. Before comparing, what we have to do is whether this is capable of decoding or not. H is capable of decoding or not. We had two conditions. It should not contain any zero column, no zero column. No two columns are identical. That is, this is 110 is not at all there anywhere. 011 is not at all there anywhere, and here no two columns are same because it is unit matrix. Hence it is capable. No zero column, no two columns are same. Then afterwards we have found this for one of the five dimensional number, which is this. Now this 100 you compare to the this H matrix only. Like here it is H matrix only. This is our H matrix. 1, 2, 3. So this is equal to the third row, our syndrome. This is our syndrome is equivalent to the third column. If it is equal to the third column, the mean R 0 1 0 1 1, this third one 1 2 3, this third one you have to catch hold of and change it as R equal to 0 1 1 1 1. This is our changed one. So that 0 to 1 is changed. After changing, the decoding of R is retain the first three numbers. Why first three numbers? Because it is a 3 cross 5 matrix. Because retain the first two numbers, I beg your pardon, because the original was 2 cross 5, retain the first two numbers, which is 0, 1. By chance, if it would have been equal to 1, 1, 0, suppose if it would have been equal to 110, this we compare and it is equal to the first column. First column means here first one you change to 1 and retain only 2 here, hence 11 becomes our code. So shall we check some of the important examples? An encoding function is given by the generator matrix G equal to this. Determine the code words and error correcting capacities. We are interested in the find the associated parity check matrix. Use H to decode. For example, this is our G. E of 0 0 is, you multiply this 0 0 to this matrix, we get this. Multiply 0 1 to this matrix, we get this. Like that, all these things. So now distance between all these, E of 0 0, E of 0 1 means distance between all these 4 points are found, 6 possibilities. Minimum is 3. Then error, therefore the code can detect 3 minus 1, that is 2 is the error detecting capacity. 3 minus 1, which is 2 by 2, 1 is our, that is single error. So 1 is our error correcting capacity. 1 is correcting capacity means single error correcting capacity. So what we did, generated using this matrix and minimum distances we found. What is a parity check matrix? We found like this. Matrix is 110 011, 2 columns, 110 to 011, corresponding unit matrix. How we decoded it? H into R to the power T. Suppose we want to decode first one, which is this one, 111 011 111 01. You multiply by taking its transpose, we get this. Since it is a zero column, whatever the code is there, received channel is there, simply first two things of that, 1 1 is our decoded one. Suppose next one multiply 110, this is first one, so change is first one to 0, change is first one to 0, so again retain 2 only, 0 1, so 0 1 becomes our decoded. So that suppose I take one more generator matrix and find the code words assigned to 110010, decode this parity check matrix, show that it is not possible to decode this one by one. Let us first decode this. Can you observe that this is 3 cross 6? So that decoding will get back 3 and after coding we get 6 dimension. For example, if I decode it, if I suppose encode it, multiply, after multiplying this, this is output 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So hence like that we get 2 6 dimensional numbers, z2 to the power 6 numbers. So now these are our code words, 110 is this, 010 is this. What we did, simply we multiplied this 010 to this matrix, okay, generator matrix, and to decode it, parity check matrix means what? This generator matrix is there, 110 first column, 011 second column, 110 first column, 011 second column. The third column is the third row here, 101, remember 101 101, corresponding unit matrix. To decode any 6 dimensional, you take first H, then transpose of this, a column of this, after multiplying you get 011. See, can you see this 011 is same thing as second one? Change is second one to 0, so it becomes 100 and retain first 3, which is 100, actually it should be 100. Second one, if I multiply all these, if I multiply this and this, triple one is there. If triple one is there, okay, then can you compare this to any of these? Triple one is not at all there, triple one is not at all there. So you cannot decode this. So either it should be a zero column or it should be one of the columns. Both the conditions are failing here for decoding, hence this cannot be decoded. So now third example, the parity check matrix for an encoding function, again 3 dimension, 6 dimension. So 3 cross 6 matrix will be there, directly parity check matrix is there. Now reverse, we have to find the associated generator matrix. So for that, this is our A transpose, we have to find A. Does the code correct all single errors in transmission? First of all, let us find G matrix. So G matrix means transpose of this. So first column triple one becomes first row here, second column 110 becomes second row here, 110 second row becomes second column, third column 101 has become third row 101. Correspondingly there are three rows here, so that 100 010 001, so here this identity matrix of order 3, unit matrix of order 3. Now we observe that two columns of H, that is second and fifth, which is a 010 and second and fifth, so they should be same. Actually if they are same, we are not, if they are identical, so we are not able to find the decoding. So here if at all we write 101 here, 101, second one is 110, so this should be 110, third one is 101 so 101. So hence we do not have this possibility of decoding, because if two columns are same, then we do not get the possibility of decoding. So what we did in the first example, can see quickly, the first example, this was generator matrix, hence multiplying all these, multiplying, suppose I take first example, generator matrix is G, multiplying this G, this G to all two dimensional code words 00011011, output is 5 dimensional. So hence we take these as code words, and the distance is of course as usual. Suppose you want to decode this, then take H matrix HRT. If this is 0 0, don't change, only take first 2, that is 1 1. If it is equal to, suppose this I want to decode, then this is a column of the same thing, 1 1 0 is the output, 1 1 0 is the first one. When you change the first one here, it becomes 0 0 1 we get, so that 0 1 is our code. If it is not equal to any of the columns, we cannot decode it. Remember, if H contains a 0 column, you cannot decode. If 2 columns or H are identical also, you cannot decode. Like that, today we saw that how a matrix also can act as a encoding function, both as a generator matrix, as a parity check matrix. What is the task of generator matrix? Generator matrix codes, that is takes a m dimension to n dimension, decode matrix, that is a H matrix, parity check matrix, decodes with a proper scheme. So, the next one, using group theory, some coset things, still better coding things we can learn, more interesting are waiting for you. Till then, bye, thank you, see you.